8:15. The kids tell me they're hungry. So, hungry it is. Oh, they're taking their clothes off already. It's so early for that. So yesterday, I went grocery shopping in the morning. And then I went and we dealt with this home inspection. And I'm going to tell you, this home inspection took forever. Home inspections are supposed to take forever. If they do a good job, they take forever, okay? But we went over into this home inspection. It started at 2:30, so we were there at like 2:15. And I didn't get home until 5:15. And I took the girls, and my mom was there. My realtor, Patty, was there. Patty's a good realtor. And it just took all day, okay? It just took a lot of time. So yesterday, I didn't do anything at the house. I got up, went out the door with my mom, got all this stuff, came in the door, got some food cooked, and, like, got the kids dressed, like, appropriate for outside, not, like, around the house dressed. Because it's one thing to be, like, look at me. I'm what we call around the house dressed. The KonMari, that Marie Kondo says, leisure clothes. We just call that stained stuff that's okay to wear around the house. Something that's been stained but still has life in it. So, actually, yeah, I'm a hot mess. So, anyway. Oh, I'm going to show you this, and it's just terrible. Like, I'm telling you, today is Friday, and today I'm not leaving the house. I'm just not leaving the house. I'm just going to work at the house. I got probably 4 more loads of laundry downstairs to do, which it's not that bad. That's cool. I can manage that. But, dude, this kitchen is terrible. Oh, there's a naked kid. All right, here. I'm just going to show it to you. Look. All right, so here, my coffee pot. And it's going to get worse. I feel like it's just stuff everywhere. Look at this. It's just stuff everywhere. Look at the floor. What is even on the floor? Like, that chunky and on the floor? So, this right here is my mission today. Need to get this hot mess cleaned up. And then my mom brought spackle over, so yay! Actually, I'm a little excited. I probably should go up and pull wallpaper still. I shouldn't even be spackling. I need to finish one thing. What? Do you want to go? You can go upstairs when we go upstairs. Not yet, though. So anyway, we'll see about getting that done. Oh, I should charge my camera battery because that's how I do the speed on that, but, blah, blah, blah. It's going to be a busy day today, but it will be so satisfying to have things back in order and reasonable again, so I'm going to make that happen, but first, I'm going to cook breakfast for those kids that are hungry, mommy, hungry. Okay, so I am in the process of getting dinner ready right now. This isn't necessarily a cooking video, but I need to, what we used to say at UPS, talk and type. So I want to talk to you, but I want to get my work done too. So I figure you could watch what I'm doing. What? Take it to Daddy. Daddy's not going to be happy that you have that. These are the tops off of my stuffed peppers. Did not throw them out, and actually what I did is I totally keep them in a strawberry clamshell. It has lots of air vents here, and I can close it and keep it hemmed up. I also have a half an onion there, so just saying, that's what I use, because nobody wants this stuff just rolling around in their fridge. And also, if it gets knocked over or whatever, it works. And the best thing of all, that stuff is free. I mean, you know, I just bought 6 of those. I don't save all of them. But when I have them and I need use of a container, especially for produce, if you're in Canada, I just grab that and use it because it's on hand. And then the other thing is I never have to wash it.
when it gets nasty, I toss it. I know that there's a lot of no waste folks out there, but I'm not at that point yet. So now I also have this chopped onion. It's that chopped onion that was on my cutting board like all that time. I'm gonna use it. I have this onion starting to get dry. Take it to daddy, honey. It's starting to get dry, so it's like use it or lose it sort of a situation. So I'm going to cut it up and throw it in here. Just gonna leave that on my cutting board. Now I am going to go over to my pan. I have a whole lot of, I have 1 pound of Duma's mild Italian sausage here. I find that some of the keys to getting a good crumble is flipping the bad boys over, like the getting the brown side at the top and poking at the brown side. That way you don't have to get it out and cut it, or there's a lot of things people do, and I'm just like, ugh, extra work. Stuff gets dirty. Like, but if you get it turned over and poke that brown side, it crumbles nice for you. So I'm gonna see what I can do about flipping this. All right, so that's looking all right. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna get all of my, sorry guys, that was my hand. I'm going to do these one at a time, as I don't have 2 hands. That's going in. And now this. This was 2.5 tops, because I think because I used a half a top for potatoes O'Brien for breakfast this morning. I put them in my fried potatoes because it tastes good. I don't have any shame in saying that that's why I did it. I do have my water trying to come up to a boil here. And I'm also going to say just up front, I'm not making homemade spaghetti sauce today because it's 11:28. And I just realized it. Like, I came in and started tooling around in the kitchen. It was 10:30. And I looked up and now it's 11:30. And oh, yeah. That means I'm not behind, but I don't have time to thaw and all that stuff with the tomatoes, so this is what I'm doing here. I need to get my garlic going. So I'm going to take you over, and I'm just going to let this kind of cook up. I'm going to show you how I do my garlic. All right, are you guys ready for, like, the bestest kitchen gadget ever? All right, I have a garlic peeler. This is what it looks like. It looks kind of like a silicone cannoli. I have my garlic here. You can see this is not peeled. Are you ready? Can you handle it? I just got the, just it's in there, you know, like nothing. Here we go. Like, I'm not even joking. Voila! Is that a miracle? It's a miracle. I know, like, look at that. That is, how long did that take? Another one in? Shtaboom! It's done, baby. I just peeled 3 things of garlic in less than, like, 8 seconds. All right, again, this is, there's nothing in it. It's, well, there's a little bit of, like, skin in there now, but this is literally, it's the magic. All right, now you're gonna ask, where do I get this device? How much does that magic device cost? All right, well, the even better news than number one, this thing stinking works. The next best thing is, I got this at Dollar Tree. Yep, it even has a hook so you can hang it up if you want there. And they come 2 for $1. My mom bought one and is like, this thing works, it's the best thing ever. I got you one. So you have to buy 2, so you have to spend $1, but You can give one to a friend. Keep one as backup. And they all come in different colors. You can get it in not just this orange. Orange is like my least favorite color. 50 freaking cents? Yes! All right, I'm gonna... All right, look at this. Do you know what this is? It's zucchini. Also, we've had a quick little development. I cannot find pre-made spaghetti sauce, so I am making an emergency batch of spaghetti sauce. And one of those things that's going to happen with this. Uh-huh, that's right, kids. Vegetables. Alright, I'm going to turn this on high, high, high. But look, my water still isn't ready, so it's not like, and it's only 11:39, so I mean, I got a minute or two. We're going to make this happen. I'm probably going to throw my garlic in because it's just going to boil at this point, and it's not going to fry it up too hot, so I'll come back with an update in a minute. Okay, so I have all of my tomatoes and zucchini melted into my saucepan. I'm going to stir it around because I realize it's kind of flat looking here, but I have my, you can see the shreds in there a little bit. My sausage, my 1 pound of sausage, I've got 3 cloves of garlic in here. I've got 3 tops of green peppers and that like 2 quarts of tomatoes. So I'm just literally getting it cooked up. I also did put a little bit of sugar in here, less than a quarter of a cup, but more than like an eighth. So it's kind of just to taste. So it'll probably need a little bit of salt too, because tomatoes always need salt. And essentially, because I'm cooking from scratch, there's no salt or sugar already in the food, so you have to add it yourself. But the good thing is almost always you add way, way, way less than the manufacturers do. So it's 11:58. You can see I've been at this for about 20 minutes now, so this is actually going together really, really quick. I'm gonna let this cook uncovered because I want it to kind of, I want it to get saucy. I want it to not be so liquidy, because if you look when I stir it, I mean, it's pretty thin. If I need to, I will add like a tablespoon of flour or so, which will help it thicken up, but this is a really kind of chunky sauce, but I like my sauce to kind of really stick to my pasta. So the other thing is if you notice along, especially like, like right here, there's some what I call foam. It's tomato foam, and in fact it's happening. That is a product of the cooking.
What happened? Stuff in there? That's a product of the cooking process of the tomatoes, and you
when that stops happening, your tomatoes are cooked. And I gotta pick this baby up, so I'll be back.
Alright, so while we're waiting for these tomatoes to cook, I'm gonna give you a quick step update from yesterday, from all that activity. I got this crying baby picked up. Oh, it's the noon alarm. Hold on. Yesterday, I did 7,500 steps, almost 76, which is kind of a lot because I didn't go for a walk. I didn't get on the treadmill. So that's a lot of steps. This kid's wearing a coat. These kids have been wearing their coats nonstop since we got home yesterday, thinking, I don't know, that maybe we'll go outside. I don't know. Which we're not going outside, so I thought I'd give you that quick update. My weight, 202.4 today, but I did start drinking coffee before it's really humid in here from that sauce and stuff. I don't know where your other hair ties are. So it could be that I drank half a pot of coffee before that, but it is what it is, I guess. Oh, look at him. I need to brush my hair and put it up. I brushed it this morning, but I just threw it up in the ponytail and, you know, it could look better. So, I'm really tired today, too. After yesterday, it was just such hard work. I don't know. We'll see what happens. I guess you always see what happens because you're watching the video, right? Duh. But, yeah, I'm going to go check on the spaghetti and cook a while. Maybe turn on a fan because we need some air movement in this bad boy. Whew, it's humid.
All right, so this is in my fridge from a couple of days ago. It's the end of my peas, and I'm putting them in the sauce.
No, we're going to
make this really as hearty as possible. So I got a minute 33. Okay, so after the first serving, this is how much sauce I have left over. And this is how much pasta I have left over. So not a ton, but that's because this is a 12-ounce box. I got to help her.
We'll be right back.
a built-in dresser over here. And this is a very tall place because I'm at the bottom of the stairs and that is the top of the second floor up there. So I am thinking that don't get your head stuck. That I'm going to use a telescoping snow scraper to try and get up there. But we're going to see how that goes. So the paper I can probably get pulled off. It's, oh, and then I have a little bit of paper up there too. So, yeah. I'm pretty sure someone stuck their head in the banister. It could be this one. You know, if you just put your head down a little bit and pull back, it'll be fine. Pull back. Yeah, I gotta supervise this. All right, here you go. Just if you push it down and then there you go. See? Ah, the drama of my house. See, I know this is really dirty, but that's because Chris touches it all the time. So, and yes, I do have paper all stuck on my floor. Oh, look. Ah, just gravy. Makes me kind of want to pull some of this right now. Oh, you can see I've already started to pull it, but this is the tall part here, so. Oh, it's so satisfying. It's hard to do this. Oh! I can get the, that's what I'm going to do for now. I can put the stairs, or the stepladder I have, because there's a good landing here. Also, this carpet looks so freaking dirty. But it does not look like that in real life, because I'm looking at it on the camera and in real life, and I'm just like, it's just not even black like that, or dark. It's just dirty. Anyway, whatever. That's what I spent most of my day doing.